بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Coming to Hadith 1472 عن عبد الله بن عمرو قال سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول أول ثلة. In another narration, أول مئة. يدخلون الجنة الفقراء المهاجرون الذين تتقى بهم المكاره. The Prophet is saying, عليه الصلاة والسلام, that the first group, in another nation, the first 100, who will enter Jannah are the immigrant poor people, whom calamities, trials can be averted through them means through their dua. Because the Prophet ﷺ, he used to say, when there's a calamity, war, anything, bring me those weak ones among you. And he used to be asking Allah by their dua as well. Then he said, هَلْ تُنصَرُونَ وَتُرْزَقُونَ إِلَّا بِضُعَفَائِكُمْ. You think that there's do you know that you will not be granted victory or provided but by the weak ones among you? And this is beautiful. How many people, how many a person, he used to be poor, but with the first child Allah granted him, Allah provides him. Wallahi. And that happened with me. With the first child I got, the provision was with him. So this is what the Prophet means, عليه الصلاة والسلام, that تُتَّقَى بِهِمُ الْمَكَارِهِ, things that people hate can be averted through them. There is nothing through them, yani through their person. There is nothing in Islam as to through a person. No, through his dua. As the Prophet said, هَلْ تُنصَرُونَ وَتُرْزَقُونَ إِلَّا بِضُعَفَائِكُمْ بِدَعْوَتِهِمْ وَصَلَاحِهِمْ وَإِخْلَاصِهِمْ. Look, bid'awatihim is an action by their dua. Is that right? It's an action. Salahihim, their righteousness. Isn't this an action? Ikhlasihim, their sincerity. Action, action, action. Not by person. There's nothing that you make dua by a person to the Prophet, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nothing. You can't say, oh Allah, I ask you by your Prophet. No. It's not allowed. If the Prophet was with us now today, for example, we say, oh Allah, I ask you by your Prophet, and it's well known that not by your Prophet means by his person, by his dua. That's why when the Prophet died, Umar said, according to Bukhari, oh Allah, when we used to be having a problem, calamity, we used to ask you by your Prophet. We used to, not anymore. And now we ask you by his uncle Al-Abbas, who was alive at that moment. When the people in Medina had a calamity. Calamity, what was the type of calamity? Dryness, no water. Does it mean that there might be some disasters and calamities in Medina? Yes. Is there an exception? Yes. What? No fever. No fever took place in Mecca after the Prophet made dua. The Prophet ﷺ came to Medina with Abu Bakr and Bilal. The first time they entered Medina, Abu Bakr and Bilal, they got sick. Then Abu Bakr started to, he was visited by his daughter, Aisha. Then she said, كيف تجدك يا أبا بكر? How do we find you, O Abu Bakr? He used to be saying these beautiful words. كل امرئ مصبح في أهله والموت أدنى من شراط نعله. Every person is reaching the day with his family while his death is closer to him than his own shoes. كل امرئ مصبح في أهله والموت أدنى من شراط نعله. And also Bilal was saying other kinds of poetry. She was saying, O Bilal, how do we find you? Aisha radiallahu anha. And that's in Sahih Bukhari. So, after that, the Prophet ﷺ raised his hands and he said, Oh Allah, purify Medina. Purify it from fever. Let its fever be on so and so mountain. Cleanse Medina from that. The Prophet said that the fever that used to be in Medina, finished, no more. And he said, Oh Allah, protect Medina, immunize Medina from the plague disease. And until now, we never heard that Medina had any kind of plague disease. In Europe, after the Prophet, yes, it caused 25 million people to die because of the plague. Because they don't know what to do, how to deal with it. In Islam, if you are inside a city where it was contaminated with plague, don't leave it. Be patient and sincere and get the good news that your death will be as a death of shaheed. For if people don't do, they'll be running away from the plague they had, but they're going to be themselves a tools of contamination, pollution. All people, wherever they go, they'll be taking this pollution with them. Isn't this a miracle? That the Prophet said, no plague will ever come to Medina, and no plague came. And the Prophet said, for example, about the eastern coast of Medina, which is Iraq and Iran. And he meant by that Iran, he said, it's the place of zalazil, earthquakes, and fitan, tribulations, as we see today. And as a result, you don't see in the peninsula any earthquake. There was a slight earthquake that took place in Tabuk, which is added to the peninsula. Tabuk is closer to Jordan today. But the place of the peninsula, it had not been hit with earthquakes until today. Until today. Some people say that, oh, the Prophet was talking about Riyadh, Najd. Okay. If this is true, then why didn't we have until now 1,400 years, not even one earthquake there? Not even one. طيب. Let's get back to the hadith. So the Prophet ﷺ said, the first group who will be entering Jannah are the immigrant poor. Muhajirun al-Fuqara. الذين تتقى بهم المكاره سمعوا وأطاعوا. They heard and they obeyed. وإن كانت للرجل منهم حاجة إلى السلطان لم تقد له حتى يموت وهي في صدره. If one of them has a need from the sultan, leader, king, etc., it won't be given to him until he dies while the need is in his heart. وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ لَيَدْعُو يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ الْجَنَّةِ Allah himself will be calling Jannah at that day. فَتَأْتِي بِزُخْرُفِهَا, then it will be coming with its adornment. وَزِينَتِهَا, and decoration. فَيَقُولُ أَيْنَ عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ قَاتَلُوا فِي سَبِيلِي وَقُتِلُوا. Allah will be saying, where are my servants? Those who have been fighting for my sake and then they got killed for my sake. Where are they? They got hurt for my sake. اُدْخُلُوا الْجَنَّةِ, enter Jannah. فَيَدْخُلُونَهَا بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ, then they will enter it without hisab. So we don't have only the 70,000 who will enter Jannah without hisab. Hisab means accountants. No. Reckoning. No reckoning. No hisab. So not only the 70,000. And note here that with every one of the 70,000, there will be 70,000 entering by his shafa'ah. Do you have a calculator? No calculator. No. But now there's something additional. In addition to that, ash-shuhada, they will enter Jannah without hisab. What about debt? Death will be before their entrance to Jannah. Because everybody have to enter Jannah pure from any debt on them, pure from anything against them, pure with their hearts, pure from any resentment, any arrogance, any envy, from anything. They should be purified before they enter Jannah. They will never be stepping Jannah before everything will be solved, even between the believers. No. So, وَتَأْتِي الْمَلَائِكَةُ فَيَسْجُدُونَ, then the angels will come and they will be prostrating to Allah. If you can, brother, tell the administration, if they can get W-40, or any of you can get W-40. Have you heard of W-40? Which will be muting the sound of the door. W-40. It's spray. Yes, it is spray. So now the sound will be muted. Bye. Then the angels will come and they will be prostrating. فَيَقُولُونَ رَبَّنَا نَحْنُ نُسَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِكَ اللَّيْلَ وَالنَّهَارِ. The angels will say, our Lord, we celebrate the tasbih of you by day and night. وَنُقَدِّسُ لَكَ, and we exalt you. مَنْ هَؤُلَاءِ الَّذِينَ آثَرْتَهُمْ عَلَيْنَا, who are those that you preferred over us? فيقول الرب عز وجل هؤلاء عبادي الذين قاتلوا في سبيلي. Then Allah will say, those are my servants who were fighting for my sake. وأوذوا في سبيلي, they were hurt for my sake. فتدخل عليهم الملائكة, then the angels will be entering to them in Jannah. مِن كُلِّ باب, through every door among the doors of Jannah. How many doors are the doors of Jannah? 8. How many doors are the doors of Jahannam? لَهَا سَبْعَةُ أَبْوَابٍ لِكُلِّ بَابٍ مِّنْهُمْ جُزْءٌ مَقْسُومٌ. It has 7 doors. Jannah, 8 doors. So they will enter through every door among the doors of Jannah, and they will be addressing the people of Jannah in this. As Allah said in the Quran, وَالْمَلَائِكَةُ يَدْخُلُونَ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنْ كُلِّ بَابٍ, سلام عليكم بما صبرتم فنعم عقب الدار. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying in this surah, and the angels are getting inside, entering to the people of Jannah from every door among the doors of Jannah, saying to them, peace be with you for the patience that you steadfast or stood fast. For your patience. فَنِعْمَ عُقْبَ الدَّارِ. How great, how excellent is this house that Allah granted you. There's a question here. Who are better? The sons of Adam, mankind, or angels? Now we're not talking about the evil people of among the sons of Adam. No, we're talking about the righteous people, the good people. Are they better than the angels, or the angels are better than them? Who? Yeah. Who is better than who?
The people.
The people are better than the angels. Are you sure? There's tafsil. Tafsil يعني a matter of detailing. Regarding our current situation now, no, they are better than us, because they are involved always in continuous tasbih, non-stop, which is not the thing we can do. Always. The Prophet said, والسلام, heaven is becoming heavy, and it has the right to be heavy. There is no space of four fingers, but it's filled with angels. One is making sujood, one is making ruku'ah. So, regarding what they are involved with, they are better than us. Because Allah described them. يسبحون الليل والنهار لا يفترون. Do you know the meaning of لا يفترون? What is the meaning of لا يفترون? I'll see the translation. Let me see my translation. لا يفترون. يسبحون الليل والنهار لا يفترون. They make tasbih during the day and during the night, and they do not slacken. You know slacken? Or slaken? S-L-A. S-L-A-C-K-E-N. They don't stop. They don't take a break. Okay, let me put it in this well-known word. They don't take break. So, as to what they are involved with, they are better than us now. But as what we're going to be granted at the Day of Judgment, we will be better than them. And this is what Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah said. We are involved in things, and the angels now are involved in things. What they are involved, engaged with, is much better than what we are engaging with. They don't need to go to the market. They don't need, you know what, you know what is their purpose? You know they are roaming. You know the meaning of the word roaming? Don't remember your Nokia. Don't remember your mobile phone when I use the word roaming. Roaming of the angels is something different. The roaming of the angels, they keep searching in the roads, in the places on earth. Where are those who are engaging themselves in remembering Allah? And when they find an assembly, they call one another, come to what you need. Come to your need. Come to what you've been looking for. Then they start to touch softly with their wings those who are joining the assembly. And guess what? After that, they will go up to Allah and they'll be mentioning the assembly to Allah. And Allah will make them witness that Allah hath grant them his forgiveness for their gathering, which had been held for the sake of Allah. Now, so the angels, now they are better than us, but if, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us and you Jannah, if we enter Jannah, we will be better than them. Hadith number 1473. He said, the first group, أول زمرة تدخل الجنة على صورة القمر ليلة البدر. I think we have mentioned this. The first group that will enter Jannah, they will be at the they will be looking like an image of a complete moon form. You know, in certain times, in the 13th, 14th, and 15th of the Arabic era, you can see the moon taking a full image. والثانية على لون أحسن كوكب دري في السماء. And the second one, the next one after that, they have the image of the best galaxy, or star. For every one of them, the people of Jannah, for every one of them, two wives. على كل زوجة سبعون خلة يبدو مخ ساقها من ورائها. Two gorgeous, beautiful wives. On each one of them, 70 khulla. Yani, it is absolutely, completely adorned. Even the shining, the brightness of its leg can be recognized even from behind of herself, because of beauty and brightness. Let those who see white skin remember that. Especially the season is changing. And we started to see what we were, alhamdulillah, so happy not to see during the freezing time. But the freezing time is going away now. And just yesterday we started to see things that we didn't have that headache for 2-3 months maybe before. Allahumma stah. Hadith number 1476, where the Mu'adh ibn Jabal said, O people of Awd tribe, Inni Rasulu Rasulillahi. He was calling this tribe. He was saying, I am the messenger of the messenger of Allah. Ta'lamun al-ma'ada ila Allah. You know the return to Allah. Thumma ila al-jannah aw ila an-nar. The return to Allah. The return is to Allah. Then either to Jannah or to fire. Wa iqamatun لا ضعن فيه. الضعين is the one. What? How should I call? Shall I use it in the current terminologies today? Indefinite leave or temporary leave? Yeah, you have temporary leave and indefinite leave. When you enter Jannah, khalas, indefinite, huh? Leave in Jannah, khalas. No death, no way, yani, no termination for that reward of Allah. No termination, no limit, no end. Once they entered it, they will never get out of it. Now, وَخُلُودٌ لَا مَوْتْ فِي أَجْسَادٍ لَا تَمُوتْ. Eternity, but no death, embedded in bodies that never die. Hadith number 1477, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, three types of eyes that will never be touched by hellfire. ثلاثة لا ترى أعينهم النار يوم القيامة. Three upon which their eyes will never see fire the day of judgment. May Allah make me and you among them. No. عين حرست في سبيل الله. An eye that was guarding for the sake of Allah. Yani, for example, those mujahideen in Syria, while they're doing this, while they're guarding, every moment in their guarding, they'll be rewarded. Every moment. And an eye that kept guarding, this eye will be protected from not only suffering fire, no, but even seeing fire. وعين الله المستعان وعين غضت عن محارم الله. How can we do that today? An eye that lowered its gaze from what Allah had prohibited. It's not easy. It's not easy. Attraction. Remember the reward, it will help. Remember the reward, that will much help. If you don't remember the reward, oh Allah, one time. Ya Rab, forgive me, I couldn't stand it.
But sometimes, you know, you take care, but when you see the reward,
then raise your sight up. Oh Allah, help me. What shall you do? Saddidu waqaribu. What's the meaning of saddidu? Hit the target. Waqaribu, if you couldn't hit it, at least something beside it. Doesn't mean that if you don't hit the target, oh, I'm not gonna shoot anymore. No. Either the target or something close to it. This very beautiful word of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. طيب. Ah, what about the third eye?
I don't understand the second one.
Let's restart it again. One eye that cried a cause of fearing Allah.
Cry.
For example, you fear Allah and you cried. Oh Allah, I fear you. Oh Allah, I committed a sin. Oh Allah, forgive me. And you kept shedding tears. This eye will not be touched by fire. Another eye that kept guarding for the sake of Allah in the war, in the battlefield. You're guarding. The third eye, an eye that kept itself away from watching what Allah had forbidden. Clear? No. Hadith number 1479, where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Al jannatu mi'atu daraja." Jannah is of what? 100 levels. Ma bayna kulli darajatayn masiratu mi'ati 'am. The distance between two levels is as the walking distance of 100 years. No. In another narration, is as the distance between the earth and the heaven. Then he said, والفردوس أعلاها درجة. And the Firdaus is a higher than those levels. Now, there's another narration which is not here, but I remember it. وفوقه عرش الرحمن. And above it is the عرش of الرحمن. Oh, it's here. I'm sorry. ومنها تخرج الأنهار الأربعة. From this Firdaus, there are the source of four rivers will be emerging from this level, the Firdaus. Four rivers in Jannah. Yani the center, the source of all the rivers in Jannah is from this place in the Firdaus. وَفَوْقَهُ عَرْشُ الرَّحْمَنِ. And the throne of Allah is over it. وَإِذَا سَأَلْتُمُ اللَّهَ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى فَاسْأَلُوهُ الْفِرْدَوْسِ. And if you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you ask Him al-Firdaus. So let's apply that. Oh Allah, we ask you the Firdaus. No. All of those hadith are authentic. Narrated by Abi Sa'id al-Khudri, that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Al-Jannatu labinatun min dhahab. What's the meaning of labina? You know the labina? Is consisted of breaks. A break is a piece of gold. Piece of gold. You know how many people die for a small piece of gold? Hundreds of people may die for a piece of gold only. While in Jannah, the house of every believer is built of gold. Built of gold. One brick is golden, and the other brick is silver. وَمَلَاطُهَا الْمِسْكِ. مِلَاطُهَا الْمِسْكِ. The mosque is furnished by musk, not by dust. There's no dust, no more dust, no more dusty wind. No, no. You don't need to go to, what do you call that? House. No, what do you call that? For accessories.
Home base.
To fill any gap. No. You don't need to have khaddama, a maid, to clean from the dust. Khalas, nothing. That system there is different. Allah is the creator of dust in this life. Now, then it will be said to Jannah, speak. Is it possible that Jannah speak? Today the radio speaks. What do you call that? This bird. Remind me. Parrot. The parrot speaks. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the parrot the ability, okay, to utter, and it has a recorder. Recorder and the parrot. It has a recorder and the capability of imitating sounds. And if you teach the parrot a good word, you'll say it. A bad word, will say it. So it will be said to Jannah, speak. What will be the speech of Jannah? The Jannah will be saying, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. Successful are the believers. That means who will be inhabiting me, living in me. Successful are the believers. Then the angel said, طُوبَ لَكِ مَنْزِلُ الْمُلُوكِ. Tuba. Tuba means, yani, it's an expression of admiring. Tuba laki. The inhabitants of kings. Do you know that the least one that will be among the people of Jannah will be king in himself? He will be given what 5 times of what the earth contains. 5 times of what the earth contains. That's the last one. Yani after him, Jannah will be blocked. After his exodus from hell, the doors of hell will be blocked, finished. No one to enter, no one to get out. That one, that very person, he will be granted in Jannah 5 times of all what the earth now contains. No. Narrated by Abi Umama, hadith number 1481, that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, دَخَلَ رَجُلٌ الْجَنَّةِ. A man entered Jannah. فَرَأَى عَلَى بَابِهَا مَكْتُوبًا. Then he saw what is written, a notice written on the door of Jannah. A notice. What is that notice? As-sadaqatu bi'ashri amthaliha. Wal-qard bi-thamaniyata'ashar. The sadaqa is multiplied by 10. But lending, borrowing is multiplied by 18. How great is that? But there's almost no more lending nowadays. It has a problem. It went with the problem of not paying back honestly. It went with those who considered the debt to be a spoil. You know the meaning of spoil? Once he takes money from you, he's intending not to pay it back. Or maybe he had a good intention, but afterwards, ya akhi, wallahi, I was truthful when I was intending to pay back. But you know what? Taking money out of my pocket, it's difficult. Yeah. That's what people do today. They don't like to pay back. Did you understand me? It's heavy. They don't want to. And the Prophet said, والسلام, and many companions, they said the same. The most beloved thing with me is when I have money paying the debt of people or donating. You have, you want Jannah? You have to show the proof of desiring Jannah by the moving of your hand. That's as the Prophet said, إلا من قال بيده قال يطلق على الفعل. القول في اللغة يطلق على الفعل. Except one who did like that. That means gave. Give, you stingy. Before the moment of death comes to you, then you say, I want to donate. You know the money. The money is not yours anymore. Finish. You stingy. Now you're saying, I want to donate to this and I want to donate to that. While the spirit is separating, is getting out of your neck, your throat. No. At that moment, You're not the owner of the money. There are people who are waiting for you. Wallah. You think if you die, your children will be for 1 year, 2 years, 3 years saying, oh, no, we wish that he stayed. We don't want the money, wallahi. No. That's the sunnah of the life. Next day, or maybe on the same day, there'll be a calculator, a human calculator in your mind. Tick, 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 tick. How much will be my share? Oh, I love you, my dad. Oh, I love you, Allah, I love you. Yeah, I know you love me. I'm not talking to you, Umar. Yeah, they will be saying, oh, then there must be calculation. How much will be my share? And how much will be, et cetera, et cetera. This is the way of life. So give. And what you give, it will be preceding you to Jannah. That's why when a person die, the angels will be saying, what did he precede? But his family will be saying, what did he leave? What did he leave back? Well, the angel will say, what did he forward? See the difference? Now, so this hadith is very beautiful. This hadith is encouraging you to prefer even to lend people and donate. Why? Because the sadaqah, there's something more. The sadaqah is multiplied by 10. While lending people money, 18, right? Multiplied. We're not talking about, what do you call that? Yani 10%. No. Multiplied 18 times. And if your colleague, if the debted person, if he said, give me more chance, this year I can't pay you back, it will be doubled for you. There is a positive riba and negative riba. Negative riba, we know it, but the positive riba is this one. وَمَا آتَيْتُمْ مِنْ رِبَا لِيَرْبُوَ فِي أَمْوَالِ النَّاسِ فَلَا يَرْبُوَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ وَمَا آتَيْتُمْ مِنْ زَكَاةٍ تُرِيدُونَ وَجْهَ اللَّهِ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُضْعِفُونَ. Wow, how beautiful is that? Translation? Let's go to translation. Subhanallah, how beautiful is that? هُمُ الْمُضْعِفُونَ. Now, عَلَيْكُمُ السَّلَامُ رَحْمَةُ اللَّهِ. What does it say? And whatever you give for usury, alhamdulillah. The translation of the Quran doesn't mention the word interest. Because this is an adornment for the evil. Attracting people with this evil, interest. The Muslim has no interest to that kind of interest. Okay, let's continue. And whatever you give for usury to increase within the wealth of people will not increase with Allah. But what you give as zakah, desiring the countenance of Allah, then those are the multipliers. And Allah will be multiplying. If you give sadaqah, it will be multiplied for you, multiplied. You know, if you are super in your sincerity, the multiplication will reach to be 700 doubles. Up to 700 doubles, if you're sincere. That's not easy. That's why the Prophet says, alayhi salatu wasalam, sabaqa dirhamun mi'ata dirham. One dirham, a currency called dirham. One dirham had overpassed 100 dirham. Why? Because one person may be having 2 dirhams. He donated one and kept one for himself. While a very rich person, if he paid even 100 dirhams, it doesn't affect him. He has millions of that. So that dirham, that this one has two dirhams only, that dirham will be more valuable in this, in the perspective of Allah, more than the 100 dirhams that a rich man paid easily. Do you understand that? I love that verse. وَمَا آتَيْتُمْ مِنْ رِبًا لِيَرْبُوَ فِي أَمْوَالِ النَّاسِ. Wallahi, I make Allah with this that I love it. Wallahi, I love it. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if He knows that, I'm saying that from my heart, to grant me Jannah for that. وَمَا آتَيْتُمْ مِنْ رِبًا لِيَرْبُوَ فِي أَمْوَالِ النَّاسِ فَلَا يَرْبُوَ عَنْدَ اللَّهِ. وَمَا آتَيْتُمْ مِنْ زَكَاةٍ تُرِيدُونَ وَجْهَ اللَّهِ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُضَيْفُونَ. Then Allah, I'll continue the verse, which is very beautiful. Allahu alladhi khalaqakum. I was debating with a Shiite one, and I said to him, do imams provide? He said, yes. Give life? He said, yes. Create? He said, yes. By Allah's will. Imagine. Why do they need permission from Allah if they can themselves create? Why do they need the permission? They're given it already. Stupid. So I said to him, Allahu Akbar. Listen to that verse. Allahu alladhi khalaqakum, thumma razaqakum, thumma yumitukum, thumma yuhyikum. Allah is the one that had created you, provided you, gave you death, and gave you life. هَلْ مِنْ شُرَكَائِكُمْ مَنْ يَفْعَلُ مِنْ ذَلِكُمْ مِنْ شَيْءٍ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَىٰ عَمَّا يُشْرِكُونَ. Is there among your partners that you take with Allah one who does any of these things? Allah is asking. And this guy was saying yes. But he didn't know that I was trapping him, this verse. And I quoted this verse for him. And he was in trouble. Now, okay, so let's get back to the topic. Now, hadith number 1482, narrated by Anas, that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, دَخَلْتُ الْجَنَّةِ. I entered, he said, alayhi wa sallam, I entered Jannah. فَإِذَا أَنَا بِقَصْرٍ مِّنْ ذَهَبٍ. Then I was fascinated with watching a palace built of gold. Gold. فَقُلْتُ لِمَنْ هَذَا الْقَصْرِ. Then I said, this palace belongs to who? قَالُوا لِشَابٍ مِّنْ قُرَيْشِ. It was built for a young man of Quraysh. فَظَنَنْتُ أَنِّيهُ. I thought that I am the person because I'm from Quraysh. فَقُلْتُ وَمَنْ هُو. Then I asked the angels, it's for who? فَقَالُوا لِعُمَرَ بْنِ الْخَطَّابِ. They said, this palace is for Umar ibn al-Khattab, رضي الله عنه. قال فلولا ما علمت من غيرتك لدخلته. If not I knew your jealousy of Umar, I was about to enter it. There's in another narration, فهممت أن أدخله. I was about to enter it. فذكرت غيرتك يا عمر. Now Umar was listening to the hadith. Imagine the Prophet is saying that to one of you. What would be your feeling? What would be your feeling? Then the feeling was Umar was that he started to cry, saying, oh Prophet, I feel jealous from you. I feel jealous from you. And he started to cry, radiallahu anhu wa arda. This is the greatest hero ever. When the Muslim hears about Umar ibn Khattab, really he feels, until today, he feels pride, the dignity of Islam. This is the fruit of the dua of Rasulullah. Allahumma a'izz al-Islam bi ahad al-Umarayn. Na'am? That's why one of the companions, and I think he's Ibn Mas'ud, said, we started to be on the status of dignity and honor since Umar converted to Islam. But before that, people used to be hiding their Islam until Umar became Muslim. And he has a beautiful story. And his death was a tragedy. رضي الله عنه وأرضاه وحشرنا وإياكم في زمرته. That would be enough for today. جزاكم الله خيرا صلى الله وسلم على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Any questions you'd like to ask? No questions at all? No questions? My son, do you have any question, my son?
Yes, I do.
You're not my son. No, I just want to see if my son has a question. Do you have a question, my son?
No,
Okay, thank you. Okay, brother, your question.
I think it's more to book. And that book is also explaining what you explained, but there's a way you explained it that makes it clearer. And the question is, when you said the Sahaba, that when he came into the fold of Al-Islam, when the Prophet made dua to Allah, and the Sahaba came into the fold of Al-Islam, brother, the Sahaba you mentioned?
Sahaba, you mean Umar?
Yes.
Umar, yeah.
And that the dignity of Al-Islam and the people went up on the stage, and yeah, they were moving around without fear.
Yes.
And that book explained to the Muslims now that if they call him a terrorist, the Muslims will say, yes, I'm a terrorist, for that if I am putting fear into the act of people doing evil, not oppressing, not terrorizing them, but actually making them to be afraid to do evil when they see a Muslim, and that we are lacking in it. They said, that book said that when that man used to move about, all evil people used to run away. When he moves about in the town, they used to hide their heads and run away. And that we Muslims now,
You're bringing a big topic. Number one, anyone who is not on the way of Allah will be terrorized by anything. And that was caused by Allah Himself. As Allah said, سَأُلْقِي فِي قُلُوبِ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا الرُّعْبِ. In another ayah, we will be throwing the horror in the hearts of the people, of the kuffar, because they took partners with Allah in which He did not allow and permit. سَنُلْقِي فِي قُلُوبِ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا الرُّعْبَ. Sorry. بِمَا أَشْرَكُوا بِاللَّهِ مَا لَمْ يُنَزِّلْ بِهِ سُلْطَانًا. Allah will be descending horror in the hearts of the kuffar because they associated partners with Him. So as a result, Allah will be throwing terror in their hearts. Despite that, we should understand that terrorism was used by those kuffar against the Muslims. But a part of that, some of the Muslims I may consider to be guilty for this, such as, for example, bombing, exploding a civilian airplane, killing people, 200 people. And people, for example, they may say, Alhamdulillah, this is grace from Allah that He enabled us to do that. Okay. How come, yeah? In that civilian airplane, there are children, women, The Prophet did not allow the killing of a woman even in the war, except for a woman that participated in the war. Then if she, you know, if she attacked, then that's another issue. But even in the war, a woman should not be killed. Once the Prophet ﷺ was in the battlefield and he saw a dead woman, he said, why this was killed? Why this was killed? He was investigating why this woman was killed. He was questioning his companions. So this is what may justify for those people to call some Muslims terrorists because of that. While we know that what they themselves did against the Muslim countries is ever worse. And I used to say this, one crime, only one crime, one. Forget about all the other things. There's one continuous crime that they always commit. Smoking. Compare this, the victims of smoking compared to the victims of 9/11. There's a big difference. Every year, you have not less than 1 million death cases because of smoking. Every year, 1 million because of smoking. So isn't this terrorism? The veto is terrorism in itself. They claim that they are supporting the oppressed. They have, you know, this their United Nations Security Nation, et cetera, Security Council. And until now, if they want to take any action against the Syrian regime, anyone among the four Pharaoh countries will be raising the hand, veto. So any action or sanction against any action that is supposed to be taken against those criminals will be frozen, no more action. Isn't this crime? It is. This is a crime in itself. This is terrorism in itself. But the Muslim should not be giving people justification to call Muslims terrorists. It should be following this one. Killing innocent people is prohibited. It's not allowed. Even if we don't have any contract or truce with the kuffar, we shouldn't be killing their civilian people. Children, women, old men and women, it's not allowed. Even when the Jews betrayed the Muslims in Medina, you know the story. What was the decision of Allah? That their fighting people will be killed, the fighting ones among them. And تُقْتَلَ الْمُقَاتِلَةِ تُقْتَلْ مُقَاتِلَتُهُمْ. That the fighting ones among them, the warriors I mean, will be killed. But not anyone else. So if we learn the sunnah, if we know how to deal, we need to know how to deal with our enemies, the way to deal with them. So they will not be having any justification, okay, against Islam. Because anything wrong you do, it will be counted not against you. No. With the Islam you carry with you. You have to be careful. Okay? That's enough for today. Thank you for your attendance. Yalla, assalamu alaikum.